Well, what's your mood today, Bing?
Rosemary, this being the first day of March, I'd say that I'm in a rather breezy mood.
Oh? How breezy?
Oh, just breezy. I'm going to sing Breezin' Along with the Breeze. That be breezy enough for you?
Well, that ought to get it.
It's a real smooth caper. It's very crisp, very blithe.
Oh, then we won't have to dive into the cyclone cellar, huh?
No, not unless you want to go down and get a jar of preserves or something, or some watermelon pickles or
sounds
some pickle lily.
Sounds good. I love them.
Won't be necessary to hoist a storm warning, Rosemary. This breeze is practically no velocity.
You mean that March is coming in like a lamb and going out like a lion?
As far as I'm concerned, it is.
Okay, lamb, sing.
The breeze, trailing the rails, roaming the seas. Like the bird is a thing in the tree, I'm pleasing to live, and I'm living to please. The sky is the only roof I have over my head, and when I'm weary, Mother Nature makes me a bed. I'm just going along as I please, breezing along with the breeze. To home.
Okay, Bing.
You got a little song for us now, Rosie?
Why, sure, Ken. I'm all set with a number called You Got.
You Got what?
You'll find out. Stand by.
Perfect hostess feeling.
You've heard about the guy who sold ice boxes to Eskimos. Well, General Electric sells sun lamps right here in Southern California, where the sun shines 365 days a year. But let's face it, there are a lot of people who have to stay indoors all day, in the office or at home. So they get their suntans at night with GE sun lamps. And you can do the same wherever you live. A General Electric sun lamp costs only $11.95 and fits in any light bulb socket. Or you can get a complete GE suntan kit with a special clamp-on holder for just a little more. A GE sun lamp will give you a year-round suntan, and a General Electric suntan won't wash off either. That was real good, Buddy and boys.
They do play well, don't they?
Yes, sir.
Well, and together.
Oh, yes, that's to be desired, isn't
it? Oh, yes. I think all orchestras should strive to achieve togetherness.
Bing, this being March 1st, have you any special word for the ladies listening?
Let's see, Ken. March 1st, huh? Well, perhaps this might be the time to tell the ladies that this year's big storms, the hurricanes, that is, will still carry girls' names. This is according to a hot flash from the Weather Bureau.
Well, was there talk of taking girls' names off the hurricanes?
Oh, yes. Didn't you hear?
No, I didn't hear.
Oh, yes. But the Bureau has decided to continue linking the fair sex with foul weather.
Well, say, girls' names being synonymous with storms, is it, you suppose, there's sort of a hidden meaning, a subliminal message lurking behind this practice, do you suppose?
No, I think not. No, really. I don't think it necessarily means that women are wild, stormy, and high-velocity creatures.
Why the girls' names, then?
Well, I suppose possibly to glamorize our big blows, that's all.
Well, gee, don't the girls ever object, especially if their names happen to coincide with the name of a current cyclone.
No, they don't, and this is quite curious, too. Women don't seem to mind being tied in with nature's violent outbursts, but the Weather Bureau does get occasional kicks from men whose wives' names are applied to particularly destructive hurricanes.
Oh, the husbands object sometimes, huh?
That's what I hear.
Oh, now, another question, then.
And that?
Do you suppose the husbands are actually the ones who are objecting, or do you suppose that the letters are dictated by the wives, huh?
You're in a suspicious mood today, fella.
Oh, I have just an inquiring, probing nature, that's all.
Well, to give you a direct answer, Ken, I'd be inclined to say no. I think the husbands are really the ones who are moved to object. Husbands, you know, regard their wives as very personal property.
Oh, I know.
And they're very touchy about them.
Naturally.
Now, on the other hand, I think the girls really enjoy the publicity, if you ask me.
Well, true enough. It's usually front-page stuff.
Indeed. And the gals love it. You know, girls will be girls.
And hurricanes.
And hurricanes.
By the way, what are the names selected for the 1960 hurricanes?
I got the list right here.
Mm-hmm.
The names are Abby, Brenda, Cleo, Donna, Ethel, Florence, Gladys, Hilda, Isabel.
Isabel?
Yes, you see, all hurricane names this year are limited to two syllables.
Oh, I see.
And to continue, there's Isabel, Jeanette, Katie, Lila, Molly, Nita, Odette, Paula, Roxy, Stella, Trudy, Vesta, and Winnie.
And Winnie. Those are the lucky names, huh?
Yes, and congratulations to all ladies whose names appear on the roster.
Hey, I just thought there was no Hurricane Rosie on that list, was there?
No, Rosie.
Oh, look at our Rosie over
there.
She's pouting.
She's hardly the hurricane type. She's too languid for that. Southern, you know. She's more the balmy, zephyr type.
Softy, huh?
Easy. Whoop. Just started to scowl a little over there. I'm saying no more. I'm cutting out. Ken, you're a diplomat. You're tactful. Smooth things over, will you?
Sure. Sure thing. Rosie, what do you say? Would you care to sing up a storm for us now?
I'm hardly the type, Ken, like you fellas just said.
Oh, no offense.
And just how did you mean that balmy?
We meant it, Rosie, as soft, as sweet and gentle. Really, I assure you. Now, it might be prudent to forget the stormy weather and switch to something more sentimental. Would you care, for instance, Rosemary, to embark on something sentimental with old sentimental me?
I would love to, old sentimental you.
Well, let's just link arms and sing. She'll be so nice to come home to.
That's a very nice idea.
You must not just drop your head on my shoulder tomorrow.
You'd be so nice to come home to.
You'd be so nice by the fire, while the breeze on high sang a lullaby.
You'd be all that I could desire under stars chilled by the winter.
You'd be so nice.
You'd be paradise to come home to and
dedicated to all the ladies listening, whether their names appear on the hurricane list or not. Now, Rosie, while I check the Weather Bureau on the latest storm warnings, will you come up with a song, huh?
You think I should?
Oh, but definitely.
My story is much too sad to be told, but practically everything leaves me totally cold. The only exception I know is the case when I'm out on a quiet spree, fighting vainly the old ennui, and I suddenly turn and see your fabulous. doesn't thrill me at all. So tell me, why should it be true that I get a kick out of you? Some like the perfume from Spain. I'm sure that if I took even one sniff, that would bore me terrifically too. Yet I get a kick out of you. I get a kick every time
for the cleanest, freshest laundry in the whole wide world is water, a washer, and instant Fels naphtha. You judge a wash by a rule of three. Is it clean? Is it fresh? Is it soft? Well, instant Fels naphtha freshens, softens, and cleans. It washes out every bit of dirt, every single time, and you don't have to add anything but water, a washer, and instant Fels naphtha. You can get the latter at your grocer's today.
Time to cut on out now, Rosie.
That's it for today, friends. But we'll be back right at this very same spot at the very same time tomorrow.
Let's all regroup then, shall we?
Yes.
Bing Crosby and Rosemary Clooney with Buddy Cole's music were presented from Hollywood, produced by Bill Morrow and Murdo MacKenzie. Join us again tomorrow, won't you?